In today's video, I'm going to show you how to save data coming in from your forms inside your WordPress database. Let's go. Now, before we begin, there's an important piece of clarification that you should understand. Typically, when you're creating any kind of form on your WordPress website, you'll use a plugin. Now, different plugins will behave differently. Some plugins, for example, the WP Forms plugin, which is one of the most popular plugins out there and we recommend it. In the free version, it does not save entries to your database. It actually sends you an email that, okay, this submit or this entry was submitted. But in the pro version, it does save entries to the database. Some other plugins have different behaviors. For example, another plugin that we recommend as a forms plugin called Formidable Forms, it does save entries in the database, even in the free version. So it totally depends on what form plugins that you're using already on your site. And if saving entries to the database is important to you, I'd recommend you check out WP Forms and also Formidable Forms and compare the functionality and see what plugin will suit your needs best on your WordPress website. Now, for this demonstration, what I've done is install the premium version of WP Forms on my website, as well as the free version of Formidable Forms on my website. You can see both the entries right here. And what I've done is create a simple contact forms for this demonstration. So if I look at Formidable Forms, this is the contact form that our contact form I've created on the site. And I've embedded it on a page already, which looks something like this. So you have the name field, first name, last name, email, subject, and message. Simple form. And for WP Forms, I've done the same thing. Simple contact form. I just kept it really simple. Name, first name, last name, email, and comment or message. I've also embedded this form on a page. This is the page. Now that you see that I've embedded forms from both the plugins on different pages on my site, what I'll do is open the forms up. I'll submit some entries. I'll also show it on the screen. And then we'll look at how the entries actually appear inside the WordPress database. All right, give me a second. I'll open both the pages up in WordPress. So now that you understand how I've set this up, I've installed two form plugins, created two different pages, embedded both the different forms on different pages. Let me also open up the pages for real users or how visitors will actually look at those pages and submit some entries from both the forms. And I'll show you how they appear in the backend of a WordPress website, right? So this is the first contact form. This is coming in from Formidable Forms. And this one is coming from WP Forms. So let me quickly speed up the video. I'll just make some entries here and then we'll see how it appears inside the WordPress database or through the plugin, but coming in from the WordPress database. All right. So let me just quickly fill these entries. So I've submitted the entry from Formidable Forms. Let me do the same thing with WP Forms. So I've submitted the entry from WP Forms as well. Let's go back to WordPress and check out how the entries look like. I'll start with Formidable Forms first. So back inside the plugin section or the admin section of the site, let's go to Formidable. Let's go to entries. This is where we'll see the entries. So you see this entry. So the ID, you have the entry key, you have the form, which is responsible for the actual entry. You have the name created by and also some details. Now, you might think, hey, where's the actual content? What the user actually submitted? Well, all you have to do is just hover over this, click the view button, and you'll see all the details up here. So you can see all these entries here. You can see your email, you can see the subject, you can see the message that was sent, and you can also see the empty field. So let's say you added a lot of optional fields, but users didn't fill that in. So you can see those fields as well. You can delete the entry, you can print the entry, you can resend emails and edit entry in the premium version of the plugin. That means you want to modify it, you can do that. When was this entry submitted? What was this? Every details, IP address, everything was recorded by Formidable Forms. And of course, you see the entry right here because all of this is actually saved inside the database. You don't actually have to go to the database by accessing PHP admin or going to the host and trying to find what entries were done. Any decent form plugin will give you this option that you can start utilizing to understand what users are actually using or what entries are using users placing on your website using any of the forms. So this is how it works with Formidable Forms. Let's also check out WP Forms. So if I go to WP Forms, I'll go to entries. And remember, I'm using the premium version. It's not available in the free version. So you see right here, I can see a simple graph of how many entries I'm getting. Simple contact form, November all-time entry graph. I'll click this simple contact form. Let's see the entries, how it looks like. You see my name, the email, the entry, and all those details, all the juicy stuff that you would expect to see, right? So if I click the view button, I'll see additional details. So now I see the name, the email, what was the comment, and what I can do is actually add notes here. So let's say it was a customer request, or if you have an e-commerce website, somebody wants to track their shipping, you can actually leave notes here, which is an interesting functionality or a very useful functionality when it comes to managing user queries on your site. You also have geolocation feature, which I have not enabled in the premium version of WP Forms. You have geolocation features, you have user journey features, and tons of other features, which can be really useful when you're working with complex scenarios where you have to address a lot of users query, or you have to address a lot of user queries all the time. And that's why having a good form plugin is important. It's not just about getting an entry and showing it on the website, but also getting additional features to manage your entries, organize those entries, leave notes, understanding what users are or how users are reaching to a specific contact form, and all that juicy stuff. And both of the plugins are very capable. WP Forms as well as Formidable Forms are very capable plugins, but I'd say they are a little bit, the functionality that they provide don't overlap 100%. That's why I demonstrated using two different plugins so that you can decide for yourself which is a contact form plugin or which is a form plugin that is more suitable to your website, right? So this was the easiest tutorial in the world, a simple way to understand how to save entries that are coming to forms on your WordPress website. Very easy. I've demonstrated two different plugins, WP Forms, the pro version, and Formidable Forms, the free version. Both the links to both the plugins are in the description of this video where you can check it out. It's just below the like button so you know what to do if you like this video. And if you did like it, a like would be appreciated. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel. I'll place some other videos on the screen that you can watch that will help you improve your WordPress knowledge. And if you're interested in improving your WordPress knowledge with easy to follow tutorials, then what are you doing? Just subscribe to this channel, right? That's all we do. That's all the videos that we create. You were watching Yuvraj from WP Beginner, and I'll catch you in the next video very soon. Take care.